What's up, guys? I'm finally back to try out the No Prep car again. I got the new ProLine Primes on. I'm also running the Faultline bead locks instead of the Titus. I ordered these wrong, but I actually like them with the aluminum hex and a little bit deeper wheel. The other change I never mentioned before is the transmitter. I'm now running a Graupner X8E. It has a nice feature that could be used perfectly for drag racing. I'm not gonna go over that. It wasn't too bad for a fresh set of tires. 187 at 41 miles an hour. Obviously, I tried correcting a little too much there and the car went for a wild ride. Fortunately, the only thing I did was really scratch up the body. Nothing's broken, so we can continue. It took me a little bit to get it to launch, but I'm pretty sure that's just because of the fresh tires. They haven't been broken in just yet. But I was able to get finally a smooth pass. I hit 43 miles an hour, 1.84 seconds, which is good, but I think it'll do better. Basically exactly what I was expecting. As I'm wearing the tires in, I'm getting better and better passes. That last pass you saw, I didn't even touch the wheel for. Not sure how well you can see these times, but that's a 181 at 44 miles an hour. And it still turned down pretty far. Right now I'm leaving at 78% throttle. If I can ramp back the full throttle in a little quicker, I think I can get in the low 70s. And just like that, 177 at 44 miles an hour. I decided to come back home to finish up this video. It's entirely too hot outside. So let's go over a few things I've noticed. Some of you may be wondering if the upgrades were really worth it based on the performance you saw. The fact is, I can't put the amount of power I want to the ground with fresh tires. These are the old tires next to the new ones, after I did burnouts on the concrete all day, breaking them in. They still need to wear in a little, and then I think you'll be shocked at how well the car actually runs. The homemade wheelie bar held up well, even with a few rolls and tumbles, so I'm satisfied with that, not touching it again. The Hobbywing ESC really shined today, even though you probably didn't notice on video. I had to play around with a few settings, but the Wi-Fi module made that really easy. Once it was set, I didn't have to touch it, and it handled the power better than the Mamba X, in my opinion. I didn't have any overheating or overpower problems, but as hot as it is outside, I was making 4 or 5 passes and then giving the car a few seconds to chill out. The Graupner X8E radio makes a huge difference in how easy it is to get the car to leave, even when the surface isn't great or you're on fresh tires like I was. I'm not gonna go into detail about what it does. Like I said, check out Tim Smith's podcast. That's where I learned about this pretty sweet radio. I could really tell how well the undercover RC drag wing was working. I know that might sound funny, but the car really felt planted once it was up to speed. I didn't feel like it was fishtailing down track at all. So even though the times and speeds may not show it yet, the car is definitely improved. It's super consistent even without much traction, and I feel confident about every pass. I don't feel like I'm guessing whether it'll go down the track anymore. Once these tires are broken in, I think we'll really see the improvement in the numbers. This car wouldn't be as good as it is without all of your help. All of the suggestions and tips have helped tremendously. Make sure to let me know in the comments what you think of where I'm at right now with it. Subscribe to the channel to catch every video as I push forward to get faster and faster. As always, thanks again for watching. Peace.